Hello, fellow Communications 12 classmates. Today I'm going to be talking to you all about the year 2013. The reason I chose this year is because, for me, I was transitioning from middle school to high school in 2013, and of course, this is an extremely awkward time for everybody, so I decided to do some research on this rather interesting era of my life. So let's get started.
As for politics, our former president Barack Obama was being inaugurated into office for the second time, and he also gave his well-known gun control speech in hopes of enacting more gun control laws after there were mass shootings in three different U.S. states.
All of us need to stand up and protect its citizens. All of us need to demand governors and legislators and businesses do their part to make our communities safer. We need the wide majority of responsible gun owners who grieve with us every time this happens and feel like your views are not being properly represented to join with us to demand something better.
Barack also gave another speech at Georgetown University addressing climate change.
This does not mean that we're going to suddenly stop producing fossil fuels. Our economy wouldn't run very well if it did. And transitioning to a clean energy economy takes time. But when the doomsayers trot out the old warnings that these ambitions will somehow hurt our energy supply, just remind them that America produced more oil than we have in 15 years. What is true is that we can't just drill our way out of the energy and climate challenge that we face. That's not possible.
As for historic events, 2013 was the year that Prince George was born to Prince William and his wife Catherine. He was born on July 22nd, and he's now the third in line to the British throne. In April of 2013, the Boston Marathon bombing occurred. Two handmade explosive devices were set off, which killed three people and injured 260 others. In December of 2013, former South African President Nelson Mandela died. The cause of his death was a chronic lung infection that had stemmed from him being incarcerated for so long. As for popular media, Katy Perry's song Roar was the most listened to song of 2013. On YouTube alone, it has a total of 2.6 billion views. It's a song about self-empowerment and speaking up, which is definitely an inspiration to people across the world to not feel ashamed to be who they are and not be afraid to speak out.
I used to bite my tongue and hold my breath, scared to rock the boat and make a mess. So I sit quietly, agreed politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point.
One of the most popular TV shows of 2013 was Orange is the New Black. It first aired in this year and has continued to be a popular show ever since. This show has numerous characters that identify as part of the LGBTQ+ community, which is interesting to the viewer because in this year, same-sex marriage wasn't even legalized in all 50 states yet.
On the other hand, sometimes you can suspect, but you're not totally sure. And so you're left sitting in that expectation, waiting for someone to break the suspense. Did that clear things up? In fact, that just made everything a lot more fucking confusing. Sorry.
As for film, Frozen was the most popular movie of 2013. It has since made over $1.27 billion and beat out the movie Titanic as one of the highest grossing films in history. This film deals with issues of self-acceptance, moving past your fears, and the importance of family.
Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be bothered me anyway.
Overall, you could say the most popular things in the media were pretty progressive. Based off of all the politics, historic events, and media throughout the year, I would define 2013 as a year of growth and advancement towards the more accepting society we have today. There is still tons of work to do, but seeing the progress America has made in the past 5 years is definitely very encouraging for a hopeful future. Thank you for listening, and I hope you learned something new today.